Happy St. Patrick's Day, room two. I know things are a little bit different right now, and sometimes when things are different, it's nice to have some extra snuggles. So, for today's read aloud with Miss Stout, I have Cuddle Bear's Book of Hugs. Now, we read a book about Cuddle Bear at the beginning of the year, but I don't think we read this one. So, let's take a look. Cuddle Bear's Book of Hugs. It is written by Claire Friedman and illustrated by Gavin Scott. Cuddle Bear loves giving hugs and cuddles when he can. But one bear can't hug everyone, so here's his clever plan. "A school for little bears," he cheers, "my Hug Academy. I teach them all my cuddling skills. Come, peek inside and see." "In cuddle class," says Cuddle Bear, "we learn what hugs can do. They cheer you up. They make you smile when you've been feeling blue." Then Cuddle Bear calls, "Practice time. Now find a partner, please. Let's keep it light. Don't hug too tight. A cuddle, not a squeeze." The bears must all keep fit and strong. They work out in the gym. And even whales might need a hug, so each bear learns to swim. They practice on an octopus to get used to all the tickles. And porcupines need special care because of all their prickles. Giraffes are very hard to reach, but they still need a cuddle. Frogs are small and slippery. Bears could get in a muddle. Whatever size, whatever shape, from teeny up to tall, or growly, fluffy, bouncy, shy, there is a hug for all. Today at last, it's hug exams, a very special day. As each bear shows its cuddling skills, the others cheer hooray! Ready? Teddy? Cuddle. "Well done," says Cuddle Bear with pride. "You all have passed the test. You've earned a yellow heart that proves your cuddles are the best." So if you want to spread some love and show friends that you care, give someone close a cuddle now, as hugs are made to share. The end. So, as Cuddle Bear says, go find someone in your family, in your house, and give them a big snuggle. And I'll see you guys soon. Bye.